And that was the first death that we experienced before coming to this world. And now, after the Big Bang started, the material world. And this Big Bang was another kun, big kun. Here let me quote from the Gospel according to Saint John. In the beginning, there was Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. Whatever has been created is through this Word. This word kun, Quran has given us the proper word. Be, and it is. So that was the first creation. But then we were made to sleep or put in some cold storage. In the meantime, this big bang, another, you know, big kun of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it took the form of small particles, very minute, but very hot. And running away from each other with a speed. And from this, Quran tells, the self-conscious creations were beings, I think you call it. And Quran tells, they were created out of fire. That was after the Big Bang of the physicists. Then, to cut a long story short, you know, there were galaxies were formed and planets and stars. And then some planets started to cool down. Our planet Earth cooled down. There was crust and gases came out of it. And from them, water was created. And there, for thousands of years, there was rain. And because, you know, by shrinking of the crust of the earth, there were mountains, there were deep oceans. And for that stage, Quran says, "Kana arshuhu ala al-ma." The throne of Allah at that time was on water. In this world, there was nothing in this planet except water. And this water then separated from each other due to the shrinking of the crust. There are the mountains and there are the seas and the oceans. And from the interaction of water and clay started the life on this planet. From a single cell to the most evolved Homo sapiens, it might have taken millions of years, yes. But then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected one Homo sapien. It was the animal of man. Still he was not human. The animal existence is coming from the earth. But then Allah blew into him, into one of the selected people from the Homo sapiens, the spirit which was there waiting in the cold storage, which was asleep. It was revived. And now we have a human being having a body coming from below. In this diagram, this is earth. And this is coming through evolution, the Homo sapien. And then that ruh, that spirit, which was asleep. And Quran says, which was under death, that has been blown into this. And now he becomes man, human being. Composed of two distinct entities. Body, or I should say better, animal being. Body plus life. Ruh and spirit is not life. Life is there. in the dogs, in the cats, all the animals. Even in the leaf of grass, it's living. So life is something else. And that spirit of God, we find it in Quran at two places. Very clear terms. Quran says, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. It's chapter 15, ayah 29. And again in chapter 38, ayah 72. Ayah, I mean verse. Actually, I don't like these translations of surah is surah, not chapter. These are not chapters of Quran. The word chapter has its own connotation. It's not applicable to the surahs of Quran. In the same way, the word verse, has its own connotation. It's not applicable to the ayat of Quran. But for the English speaking people, we have to use those words. So maybe you find I say sometimes surah and sometimes chapter. So in Surah Al-Hijr 15 and verse 29 and Surah Sa'd, which is number 38 and the verse 72, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ. Allah had said to the angels before the creation of Adam, when I have completed the creation of this man, Bashar, وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي, and then I have blown into him from my own spirit, then you bow down before him in prostration. فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. So the animal of human being, homo sapiens you may call it, it was an animal, not man. But in the last of Adam wa Nuhan, Allah chose one of that species of homo sapiens, an individual, and blown into him the spirit. In these two verses Allah calls my own spirit. But what we mean is, the spirits which were very close to Allah, very close. The pre-Big Bang era of this creation. So Allah blew that spirit into it. And what will happen then? Then comes another death. We live here, this is our worldly life, which we mistakenly think that this is the life. This is not the life. This is one phase of our life. And this is the second life. I told you, we had the first life only as spirits. After that creation ex nihilo. And during that, the covenant was taken from us. وَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. And then we were put to sleep or put to death. Then we were revived. And there is a hadith which is very important. I have written down in Arabic. This is one of the most authentic ahadith tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In ahadakum yujma'u khalquhu fi batni ummihi. Every one of you, his creation takes the form in the womb, arba'ina yawman nutfatan. For 40 days it's nutfa, a speck. Summa yakunu alaqatan misla dhalik. Then again, 40 days as alaqa, something hanging from the wall of the uterus. Summa yakunu mudghatan misla dhalik. And then it becomes like a piece of meat which is chewed. So these go to make 40 plus 40 plus 40, 120 days in the womb. After 4 months, summa yursalul malaku fayanfakhu fihi ruh. And then the angel is sent and he blows into this embryo the spirit, the ruh, which was there in the cold storage. And now he is a human being. Before that, the embryo was living. It was not dead. Even the spermatozoan is not dead. The ovum coming from the mother is not dead. They are living organisms. And for these 120 days, it was living, but it was animal existence only. But then, when this spirit has been blown into it, joined together, we don't know how. Up till now, we don't know how life is attached to our body. What's the point of contact? Life. What is life? It is connected with which organ of ours? We don't know. So this combination of animal being plus the spiritual being, we can't say how it is. But it is there, the two animal being and then the spiritual being. Then what happens at death?